I have been crying out. There is a burden in my heart for a new kind of generation to be raised up. And I believe that's one of the callings that God has given me, that I will speak forth the word of God without fear or favor, to proclaim what God is speaking to this generation. Because the time has come for us to stop playing church, for us to stop going through the motions and become a church that is powerful, a church that is on fire, a church that is dedicated, a church that is passionate after God and what breaks the heart of God and not the things of this world. The Bible says to us in the book of 1 John chapter 2 and verse 15, that love not the world, nor the things in this world, for everything in this world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, the pride of life, is passing away, but whoever does the will of God will endure forever. Church, I sense in my spirit there is urgency in the spirit. I don't know this word, who is going to listen to it, but I have to speak what God is saying. There is urgency. It is not business as usual anymore. We cannot afford to live like it's business as usual. We cannot afford to do things like it's just normal. It is not normal. The world is changing right before our eyes. And the only men and women that are going to make it in these days are those who are saying, I am for God. And as long as I'm for God, I don't care for nothing else. I'm going to do what God wants me to do. Whether things are good or not good, whether it is in season or it is out of season, whether everything is working out on my side or whether things don't seem to work out, I'm going to pursue this calling. I'm going to walk this narrow path. I'm going to do what God has called me to do until I see the Savior, the one that called me. He is my audience. I'm just serving the audience of one. I sing to the audience of one. I preach to the audience of one. I do everything for the audience of one. As long as he's pleased, it doesn't matter who I displease. As long as he is approved, I'm approved of him, it doesn't matter who disapproves of me. So God is calling us, church, to arise to a new place. I feel the anointing of God on this word. And I believe it is the season for a holy people, a holy priesthood. Remember, it's not just any other priesthood, but it is a holy priesthood. 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 5. The Bible says, ye also as lively stones are built up a spiritual house, a holy priesthood, holy priesthood, set apart, kadosh. That word kadosh also talks about sanctuary. And I was preaching here about 2 weeks ago. The Bible says when Israel came out of Egypt and the house of Jacob, out of the people of a strange language, Israel became his dominion. Judah became his sanctuary. That word there means that Judah became kadosh, became holy. And the moment they became holy, the Bible says the presence of God went before them. The presence of God went before them. The mountains just had to skip like rams. The Jordan had to turn back. The sea had to flee. The Red Sea had to part. I believe the days that we're about to see, as the church begins to march to get back, get out of Egypt, get out of the systems of the world, get out of the ways of doing things like the world, being like the world, singing like the world, preaching like the world, trying to substitute the world in the church and bringing things and that are not of God, and trying to offer strange fires, bringing strange fires in the house of God, and mixing witchcraft and occultism and all kinds of things and trying to use them in the house of God. I believe the distinction is coming, and God is raising a people that are holy. Holy means there is no mixture. Glory to God. It is pure gold. There is no mixture. There is nothing that is mixed. Today we're having so much mixture. You know, you see people and they have a great following and they speak the word of God and they preach the word of God, but the spirit behind them is a mixture. It is a mixture with all kinds of things, and God is putting a distinction. I believe there's going to be a distinction. There's going to be a clear demarcation. Now, those who are doing whatever they're doing will continue to do that. But the world is going to see the true servants of God rising up. And these are people that are holy. These are priests that are holy unto God.